Morning, everyone. You know, we had another jobs report yesterday, another, frankly, disappointing jobs report. This economy is not creating the jobs that the American people are looking for. Their wages are stagnant. And part of the problem is that we've got the whole threat of Obamacare continuing to hang over our economy like a wet blanket. Employers scared to death in terms of what they have to do and what they don't have to do, afraid to add new employees. And, you know, when you look at the problems with Obamacare, all the focus here lately has been on the website. Clearly, there's problems with the website. But I would argue that the problems go much further than that. How about the report over the last couple of days of the hundreds of thousands of Americans who are finding out that they're going to lose their coverage because the plans they have today don't qualify under Obamacare. And when you begin to look at these hundreds of thousands of people, I think what you're going to see at the end of October are more Americans are going to lose their health insurance than are going to sign up at these exchanges. This is a very serious problem. It's affecting our economy, and it's affecting the ability of the American people to find the job that will help them take care of themselves and their families.
Good morning. The rollout of Obamacare is nothing short of a debacle, and the American people are now fearful of their health care. I mean, they're downright scared about what's going to happen with their health care next year. And all we're hearing from the administration really is really unsatisfactory in terms of answers to the many, many unanswered questions. Yes, we all know the website doesn't work, and the administration keeps saying, well, just to the subscribers who want to go on, say, go and try again. Well, again, there's so many unanswered questions that is adding to the fear of so many American people. And what's not helping is a lack of transparency on the part of this administration. This morning, I know that HHS officials will be up briefing the Democratic caucus. No intention initially to say that they were going to brief Republicans on what's going on. Last night, we learned that federal officials asked insurers not to release numbers for the exchanges in terms of signups. We still don't know these enrollment numbers. And HHS is blocking third-party verified traffic data. This is not transparency, and this is adding to the confusion and the fears surrounding the rollout of Obamacare. Now, in a couple of months, the Obamacare mandate tax is going to kick in, and many Americans are going to have to pay as much as 1% of their income to the federal government if they don't sign up on Obamacare. So how is that fair? I mean, with so many unanswered questions and the problems arising around this rollout, it doesn't make any sense to impose this 1% mandate tax on the American people. And that's why we Republicans remain committed to delaying that mandate tax of Obamacare so that finally we can get the answers that so many people are seeking and we can try and reassure the millions of Americans who are growing in their fear about what this all means for their health care.
You know, it's another day in a new glitch for the Obamacare rollout. That's why only 12% of Americans, the latest CBS poll, says that it's going well. More than half believe it's not. But as I listened to the president do his press conference that we will handle it, we will fix it, it just rings back to the moment when he was proposing Obamacare and said, if you had your health care and you liked it, you can keep it. It's not a glitch when an American citizen receives a letter and says their current health care, they will no longer have it. Many of the constituents that I have that I come out and see, the frustration that it is not fair in the process, that they don't have the health care that they can keep it, and if they go onto a website, they cannot see what they can have now. So when you look back and you look at the arguments, the complaints, the transparency, and the accountability that we've asked for, none of that goes away. I think the focus will now be on where is the accountability in the process, and where are the answers?
Moms, dads, seniors, young people continue to struggle all across this country, whether it is those that are out of work trying to find a job and the economy that continues to struggle, or those that are trying to get health insurance or losing their health insurance or having trouble getting their health insurance. As leaders here in Congress, our commitment is to continue to work on issues that are going to create jobs, that are going to create opportunities, and also ensure that people do have access to quality and affordable health care. The concerns are coming in every day right now, and the concern that actually this health care law is going to make it harder for people is going to make it, it's actually going to make it worse for more people than it's going to help. And that's why we're launching the www.gop.gov Your Story, to have people all across this country share their story dealing with the new health care law, so that we can go to work to ensure that moving forward we can take the action to help individuals, give them the protections that they need with this law. The delay of the individual mandate, the tax, the fee that they are facing, that employers have been given a pass on, we need to provide that fairness to individuals and families all across this country.
Conan said the other night, Obama is now urging Americans having trouble with the website to call 1-800, a 1-800 number. The 1-800 number is 1-800. We didn't think this through. Whether it's Fallon or Conan or Jon Stewart, Saturday Night Live, all of the jokes go on and on and on. But nothing is funny about losing your health care plan when you already had what you liked and you wanted to keep it. Nothing's funny about being forced on a website that doesn't work to buy health insurance that you don't want and can't afford. And it's even less funny when a government tax is hanging over your head and you don't have hours on end to go through the whole circus. This Obamacare exchange has been a complete and total failure, and it's unacceptable. The American people deserve better.
Morning, I'm Congressman Tim Murphy of Pennsylvania, Chairman of the House Energy and Commerce Subcommittee on Oversight and Investigation. Tomorrow we're going to have a hearing about the exchange website, and it'll be about the facts. We're approaching this investigation in a thoughtful and deliberate way. Here's what we know so far. HHS budgeted $55 million for just one company to build a website. Less than a year in, the agency had spent $93 million and then has since frittered away $300 million. In addition, other companies were hired to work on this website, and all told, more than $500 million was spent on a website that just doesn't work. The Energy and Commerce Committees will be real working hearings continuing our ongoing investigation into what went wrong and getting answers on the record, first with the contractors and next week with Secretary Sebelius. Repeatedly, over the last year, our committee and subcommittee was told by numerous administrative officials, don't worry, everything is fine, we have this under control. We know that that simply was not the case. Either they didn't know what was going on in their own offices, or they were deliberately misleading us and the American people with the hope of avoiding us from knowing what was really happening. Given all these questions, we should press pause on this president's tech surge, where he wants to spend untold more amounts of money to throw that after a bad website when we don't really know if this one is even salvageable. This tech surge is comparable to trying to fix a car by overhauling it while it's still rolling down the highway. At some point, you have to decide, can it be fixed, or do we scrap this and get a new one? If 55 different contractors could not successfully build, test, and run a website in 3 years at a total cost of over $500 million, why should we believe the administration is capable of fixing it in 2 weeks, especially with someone who doesn't even have tech experience? With these hearings, we're going to find out. Did the breakdowns occur with the IT contractors, or were they told to do it this way by HHS? Did the outside contractors notify HHS when there were problems? How many people have been able to sign up using the website? Are they even capable of knowing how it's working? Was the site designed poorly because the White House sought to hide it from the public and hide the massive premium increases families are seeing? And why has the president tapped an individual to fix a technology problem without any technology problem experience? While we work to get the answers, we are deeply concerned about the number of Americans who are being told they will no longer have insurance. They are looking to this as an answer, and throughout the initial rollout of this, when Congress was voting on this, and it was we were pushed away from being able to work on this, we were told repeatedly that this website would be a wonder, that people would be able to look at it, compare policies, and make thoughtful and informed decisions about what's going on. Well, we still wonder what's going on and wonder why the American people cannot possibly make thoughtful, informed decisions about their insurance, and they're quite frightened. Thank you.